It's early spring, and this newly emerged Luna Moth rests on the leaves of a birch tree. Her abdomen is swollen with eggs, and after mating the previous night, she's ready to deposit them. She glues her eggs to the branches of the tree in small batches. Her abdomen gradually shrinks as she depletes her supply of some 200 or so eggs. As with most moths, she has no capacity to feed, and her life as an adult will last little more than a week. Some 10 days after the eggs are laid, they begin to hatch. The tiny caterpillars set off in search of food soon after they hatch. The leaves of the tree are still young and tender, and the caterpillar feeds without difficulty. Its only function as a caterpillar is to feed, and its body is well adapted to this task. A prominent labrum at the front of the head is deeply grooved. The groove serves to guide the edge of a leaf between a set of powerful dark-colored mandibles that sever the plant tissue. The curved head capsule fits precisely the crescent-shaped cuts. The caterpillar has 8 sets of legs, allowing it to straddle the leaf. Thank you. The abdominal appendages, the prolegs, terminate in hook-like structures termed crochets that provide secure perches on the branches of the host tree. Between bouts of feeding, the caterpillar rests motionless so as not to attract attention of birds and other predators. After 4 weeks, the caterpillar has stored sufficient energy to carry it through the whole of its adult life, and it spins a cocoon in which it will metamorphose to the pupa. Lunas that occur in the northern part of their range, such as this one, spend the winter within their cocoon and emerge the following spring. This moth is emerging from a cocoon that has fallen to the ground, and it struggles on the loose surface. To expand its wings, it must find a place where it can hang suspended. Having climbed to a branch, the feral moth expands its wings by pumping fluid into the veins. Long tails of the hind wings are the last to expand and are thought to interfere with echolocation by bats, which prey on the moths when they fly at night. The receptors on the antennae of this newly emerged male are largely dedicated to detecting a pheromone released by the female moth. The female in the foreground succeeded in attracting a male, and they are mating. Although their days are nearly over, to the degree that she's successful, the female will pass on the essence of her life and that of her mate to a new generation of Lunas.